day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, today we're going to play in Sim Lab. Let's start by hitting Create and New 3D Design. We are going to start by naming it, let's call this Spinning Target. We're going to build with a cylinder. When you bring it out, I'm going to tell you to hold down Shift. We'll stretch it to Crazyville and then type 30 for the measurement. And then we are going to change the thickness to 2 and press Enter. I'm going to leave the sides at 20 so it's less complex. We're going to bring another piece and set it on top. We're going to stretch it to Crazyville while holding Shift, but this time we're only going to type the number 3 and press Enter. If you hit F for Fit View, we can zoom in and we're going to stretch it longer. I'm going to tell you to click this and let's type 35 for the height. Take its sides and we're going to make it down to 8. Friends, we do this because the less complex the shapes are, the better they work when they are axles. We're going to click a line, which is the letter L. We're going to choose center and center, and then we can hit group. I do want to remind you, if you look at the center from this corner, it does make more sense. Here's the group button, or you could press Control G. Now we want something to spin around this. I'm going to recommend the torus. When you bring it out, we want to make sure with cruising, we set the torus on the top of that shape. We're going to change its radius to 9. We're going to make the tube 1. We are going to stretch it taller. And then we're going to change the sides to 8 and 8. Once again, this is a simplicity thing for Tinkercad when it renders the shapes. It just makes it work better. Select them both. Choose L for a line. I'm going to make the orange one the boss, and we want middle. Check it from a corner, and we want middle. Just like that, we've made our holder and our spinner. Now let's add some fun panels. We're going to do that with the cylinder as well. This one we're going to set right on the work plane. We're going to keep the measurements except make it skinny. And then also I'm going to change the sides to 12 so it's less complex. I'm going to look at it from a corner, and friends, we need to find this rotation handle. Hold down Shift, and we're going to rotate it 2 clicks, or 90 degrees. Don't forget you can type that number. We're going to press D for drop, and there is target number 1. Now we're going to do Control D. Shift nudge across until you think it's pretty close. We're going to Shift select those 2, and we're going to do Control G, or group, to group them. We did that, friends, because now we can shift select the center post, choose L for align or the align button, and bingo, we already had it in the middle. How crazy is that? I am going to put it in the middle this way as well, though. We're going to make one more set of paddles, do Control D. This time we're going to look at it from up here. Notice you could rotate inside the shape to do 22.5 degrees, outside to do 1 degree, but we are going to hold down Shift, and we're going to go 2 clicks, so we have 4 paddles. Now we want this to be aligned with these, so we are going to Shift select, choose a line, make this the boss, and bingo, we're going to put that right in the middle. Let's Shift select all of that, Shift click, Shift click, Shift click, let's group it. And friends, this is our spinner. I'm going to make the colors a little more fun and fantastic. Click on this one. Let's make it a custom color. Let's go out here into the wacky greens. And we're almost ready to test it in Sim Lab. The only thing we need to do is raise it up. I'm going to do that with Control Up or Control Shift Up so it moves even faster. F to give us a better look at it. And bam, let's take it to the Sim Lab. Now in Sim Lab, things are either static or dynamic. This is the button right now. You can see it was dynamic. Bingo, we're going to make it static. And friends, when we hit play, we have got our apparatus. Now we can throw things at it and try and spin it. Bingo, it is a spinning part. Now here's where the fun happens. We can pause this. We can back up, we can double check and see what it looks like. That is pretty fun and fast. If we hit reset, we can also change our materials. Right now, this was plastic. If you look at this list of materials, which one do you think is going to spin the fastest? Well, that's what I'm going to leave to you to challenge. Like, I'm going to just for fun make it bouncy rubber. I'm going to click on the pink one, and I'm going to change it to polystyrene. And friends, once you make the material change, you can go back, hit play, and give it another test to see which one moves the way you want. Now friends, when you hit pause, you can back it up. I also want to show you that you can share this with the world. It is so cool when you click up on share, you can pick which style of video you want. I'm going to stay with 16:9. You can do a small format or a large format. I'm going to stay with small today. And when you hit create video, it takes your project and turns it into a video you can play with. I'm going to save mine to my downloads folder. I do want to also let you know you could save images. I'm going to cancel out here. Friends, I also want to let you know I have got tutorials I will put up here that show you how to record entire projects using Clipchamp. It's a lot of fun because you can record longer clips, you can add slow motion, and you can make fantastic videos with your Sim Lab projects. Finally, friends, when you're done, you can return to the main Tinkercad design space, and then don't forget you can make your project look a little cooler with a awesome background. You can also shut off the grid. You'll notice that is a much cooler view. You can take a screenshot of it. And then of course, friends, you can show the world what you made by simply clicking on the Tinkercad dashboard. Click up here on the properties button. Of course, make sure you give it a name, like mine is going to be Spinning Target Tutorial. And then give it a description. Of course, if it's one of mine, you know it will have a tutorial. And then down below, give it some tags. Remember, friends, if you ever make something cool and want to show it to me, if you type HLMT23, I check that tag almost every day to see the cool things that have been shared with me. Finally, make sure you set it to public, and then I always set the attribution to no derivatives because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL Mod Tech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL Mod Tech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.